Hello everyone, welcome to the subject of helicopter dynamics. I am Professor Srinidhi. This video will be discussing about equilibrium about the flapping hinge of the helicopter rotor. This video, the topic of discussion is about an introduction, then notations used for equilibrium equation, then centrifugal force equations, and then finally equilibrium equations. Now the image shown is a rigid aeroelastically stiff rotor blade flapping about a hinge located at a distance E into R from the rotational axis. Now we have to consider a mathematical analysis of a rotating flapping blade. The equilibrium position of the blade is determined by the balance of aerodynamic and centrifugal forces, CF. The contributions from the gravitational forces on the blade are very small relative to the other forces, and hence gravitational forces can be neglected. Because the centrifugal forces are very much larger than aerodynamic forces, the flapping angle will be beta, which is usually quite small. That is, helicopter rotor, you can say it is between 3 to 6 degrees. First, we have to assume that flapping hinge is at the rotational axis. In helicopters with the rotor type of teetering rotor design, this is usually E is equal to 0, and the flapping hinge is always offset to up to a very small distance from the rotational axis, but this does not alter the fundamental physics of the blade dynamics problem. The rotational speed about the axis is omega radians per second, which is a constant. Now we have to assume that a uniform mass per unit length of the blade will be m, lowercase m, and the mass of the full blade is capital M. Consider a small element of blade of length dy. The mass of this element is m into dy, and then centrifugal force is FCF. Starting with the centrifugal force, the contribution of this small element of length dy to the centrifugal force acting in a direction parallel to the plane of rotation is dFCF, that is dF is equal to m dy into y omega square, that is dFCF is m omega square y dy. The total centrifugal force acting on this blade will be integration of dFCF, that is integration from 0 to R m omega square y dy. Integration of y is y square by 2, that is m omega square r square by 2, which is uppercase m omega square r by 2. Here uppercase m is the mass of uniform blade, that is equal to lowercase m into r. You have to notice that here the centrifugal force increase linearly in proportion to blade mass and length, and are also proportional to omega square. If the blade is coned up at some angle beta, then the contribution of this small element to the centrifugal force acting in a direction perpendicular to the blade is dFCF sin beta. That's equal to m dy into y omega square sin beta. That is, it is almost, since beta, the coning angle, is very small, that is 3 degree to 6 degree, the perpendicular element of centrifugal force will be m y omega square beta dy. Next, coming to the concept of equilibrium equation, So in order to find equilibrium equation, we consider two things. One is flapping hinge is at the rotational axis. That is the first case. The moment about the flapping hinge at rotational axis as a result of centrifugal force produced by all the elements will be MCF is equal to integration of 0 to r m omega square y square beta dy. That is, now you have to integrate y square, that is y cube by 3. So that gives you the equation m omega square beta r cube by 3, uppercase m omega square beta r square by 3, which gives you the moment about the flapping hinge as a result of centrifugal force, MCF is equal to 2 by 3 FCF r into beta. The aerodynamic moment about the flapping hinge, that is m beta, depends on the distribution of lift L, capital L, across the blade. That is, m beta is equal to minus integration of 0 to r ly dy. Again, you have to notice here the negative sign. Why the negative sign? This indicates that the aerodynamic moment is in opposite direction to the centrifugal moment. The rotating blade will reach an equilibrium position where the centrifugal moment about the hinge is equal and opposite to the aerodynamic moment about the hinge. Therefore, the equilibrium equation can be written as m beta plus mcf is equal to 0. Since both are equal and the moment about the flap hinge will be negative, so it is 0. So finally, the equilibrium equation can be, or you can say the Koenig angle formula can be, beta naught is equal to 3 into integration of 0 to r ly dy whole divided by m omega square r square. Now this result is valid for any form of aerodynamic over the blade. Also, you have to note that the flapping hinge is assumed to lie at the rotational axis of the rotor. In the image, your ER, where E is equal to 0. So obviously, your flapping hinge point will be at the rotational axis. Now coming to equilibrium equation, where flapping hinge is at a small offset from the rotational axis. This offset will be E into R. So in practice, the flapping hinge is not normally at the rotational axis except for your teetering rotor design, but it is at offset of a small distance E into R. Usually E will be less than 0.15. In this case, the centrifugal force moment about the hinge is MCF, of course, that is equal to integration E from ER to R m omega square y square beta dy. That gives you m omega square beta r cube 1 minus e cube by 3. That is equal to uppercase m omega square beta r square 1 plus e by 3 plus o of e square. Here o of e square is a constant factor, and uppercase m, that is mass of the full blade, full length blade, is mr into 1 minus e. Next, the aerodynamic moment about the flap hinge, m beta, is equal to minus integration from er to r ly dy. Again, you have to note that it is the sign negative, which means that aerodynamic moment is in the opposite direction to the centrifugal moment as discussed previously. Finally, the Koenig angle in this case, that is flapping hinge with the small offset, will be, or equilibrium equation of flapping hinge at offset will be, Koenig angle beta naught is equal to 3 into integration from ER to R ly dy whole divided by m omega square r square into 1 plus e. The important point to remember is that the coning angle increases in proportion to the rotor thrust and decreases inversely with centrifugal force. In other words, increasing either blade mass or rotor speed will decrease the coning angle. So coning angle can also be defined as the ratio of blade lift to the centrifugal force. So in this video we have discussed about equilibrium, about the flapping hinge of helicopter rotor. We have discussed about what are the assumptions made, what are the considerations made, then what are the notations used in this equilibrium equation. Then we have discussed about the force, that is centrifugal force in the direction parallel to the plane of rotation and centrifugal force in the rotation perpendicular to the plane of rotation. Then we have discussed about the equilibrium equation, that is moment, aerodynamic moment, about the flap hinge and moment, about the flapping hinge as a result of centrifugal force. Now adding these two you get is equal to zero. So aerodynamic moment about the flap hinge will be negative, so that is why it will be zero. Hence the equilibrium equation or coning angle formula will be 3 into integration of 0 to r ly dy divided by m omega square r square. Next we are considering equilibrium equation of a flapping hinge at offset e into r from rotational axis. Then we get the equation for equilibrium or coning angle 3 into integration e r to r ly dy divided by m omega square r square into 1 plus e. With this we have concluded with the video. If you have any doubt or clarification, please comment on the section below. Also like, share and subscribe to the channel. Thank you.